Previously on
Treff Gaming!
He achieves Ultra Instinct Nerd! How did he achieve this power level so fast?
How can I repay you? Can you please make a cool combo negate video with Metal Pose?
Metal Pose. Sorcerer and Metal Pose are like peanut butter and jelly. The crazy, crazy potential of it.
Episode 2. Trip seeks help to defeat Nerd Trip with an amazing Metal Pose deck profile.
Yo, Nerd, Triff, teach me Ultra Instinct.
No.
I'll kick your ass.
You can.
Sorry.
It's okay. It's okay.
Be right back.
Okay.
Okay.
Bye.
If I think hard enough, I'm sure I can find a way to destroy Nerd Triff. There must be a way. Think, Steven, think. I wonder what my dog named me. You drop soap on the floor. Is the floor clean or the soap dirty? Nerd Triff, I'll destroy you. I'm hungry. Let's see what my kitchen got in here. You can't think on an empty stomach. Maybe some pasta? Yeah. What the hell? What the hell is my phone book doing in here? But wait a second. Maybe one of my friends can help me. Let me see what we got in here. Party Triff, no, Juanito. Oh shit, Dr. Triff! Dr. Triff can help me defeat him. I'm gonna call him.
Hey. Busy? Yes. I need appointment. No?
Listen, Triff, and you listen well. I love Metal Pose so much, okay? And you didn't post a deck profile in your last amazing video, which was one of the most remarkable videos I've ever seen, which everyone should go subscribe to right now and definitely watch it in the link in the description below. But you should definitely make a deck profile, and only if you make a Metal Pose deck profile right now, then I will help you.
Great, I'll be waiting for you. See you then. Bye.
Okay, great. I'm waiting for you.
See you then. Bye.
Hey, if the doctor wants a Metapod deck profile, he gets a Metapod deck profile. That's what it takes to get training to destroy Ultra Instinct Nerd Triff. Then so be it. What we're going to do for this video is a deck profile for the doctor, obviously. But also on top of that, a little combo tutorial. Because I cleaned up / polished the last combo tutorial I did in my last video. So, first off, if you haven't already, go check it out right now, okay? Because that combo tutorial is going to be vital for you to understand it. But you see the hand over here? It's a damn good hand, just like every hand, okay? We built it a lot smaller of a deck, 25 cards, to really ensure that we're going to draw a servant or ways to get Jackal on board to get all the plays through. Because if Sorcerer resolves, the whole combo revolves around Pendulum Sorcerer. I'll do the combo super quick so you guys understand. I'm just going to play quick. Just pay close attention. We want to get Jackal out with the Demian. I got 3 counters right now. The whole point of the deck is infinite spell cards and as many ways to get a Jackal on board before you Petrol Summon as possible with the most consistent way to do it to ensure that your play goes through. And if your play goes through, the Metal Foe Perform Ball combo that I'm going to show you guys, looping Mithrilium, some Perform Ball cards, etc., is going to end up on infinite gates and you're going to auto win. So, as you see here, like, I'm going to try and go a little slow, but at the same time fast, so you guys understand it. Because really, there's not much to explain here. Everyone knows what this deck does up until after before the Pendulum Summon. You just make Electrums and watch your opponent squirm and cry. We do a little cool combo there. We search for Abductor before Sorcerer. But the game plan really, don't worry for the ones who are here for the deck profile. We'll get to that for the Doctor, obviously. Maybe for you guys too. Hey, subscribe, by the way, if you haven't already. Anyways. You want to get Abductor to search the Sorcerer if you have spell cards in your hand to get the counters, but if not, just send the Sorcerer with the Electrum. You want to Pendulum Summon the Sorcerer plus basically anything else. The Pendulum Summon is not doesn't need to be huge. We're going to get the E-Tele out there only because Metal Foe Stealing is going to pop it. We need the combination to be popped by the Sorcerer to resolve this combo. And the idea of the combo here is Sorcerer is going to pop the combination to add the one Metal Foe you need in hand. And it's gonna pop the scale because after it pops the scale, it's gonna free up that scale. We just need one scale free so we could use a Metal Foe that Sorcerer is gonna add back. And the two Perform Balls that Sorcerer is gonna add back is gonna be vital for the combo. It's gonna add Yugo Golem, which is gonna loop with Mithrilium twice, and the Perform Ball Dragon to be able to do the Guard Dragon combo, which you're gonna summon off with Saryusha. And Yugo Golem is gonna be able to fusion summon for free twice. Because it'll add back the fusion material and Mithrilium will float. So you're fusion summoning for free and getting lots of pluses. And then Mithrilium will add back Yuga Golem because it's not a hard once per turn, which is amazing. And this is really just the gist of the combo. So you're going to want to use Mithrilium to use Electrum. So you're going to, just like the old days, you use Electrum three times, stick to the game plan, use Electrum three times in the turn. But this time, you use it two times in the turn. Mithrilium is going to float twice, replacing itself. And Yuga Golem is going to fusion for free by adding back the material twice. And Mithrilium is going to add back the Yuga Golem to be able to do that twice. So it's a cool little loop that goes on. No, it's not a huge loop, and that's not forever, but it's like a mini loop that go on for a little bit. So Sorcerer allows all that to happen. If you pendulum something just a Sorcerer, all this is possible. And that's why getting a Jackal first to protect Electrum is important. But again, 90% of the time, you're either going to have Jackal negating a hand trap, or they're not going to have a hand trap. One or the other, 90% of the time that'll happen. So here, this is the best play, what I should have done, Electrum, as I'm doing right now, but win Electrum first. But I wanted to show you guys a little cooler play, so I'm going to take all this back. But the best play right here is go Electrum first, and then you're going to fusion with the Electrum to go into Mithrilium. And Electrum is going to be the material for Mithrilium. But I'm like, you know what? That play would end on 7 interruptions. But I'm like, you know what? What's a Metalfold board without an Alkahest? So I'm going to do a different route here to end on an Alkahest, where you Mithrilium first, and then you Electrum, and then you Alkahest, as opposed to Mithrilium, and then... opposed to Electrum, then Mithrilium, and then you're going to use Mithrilium at the end to Sayusha. But this is just better to end on an Alkahest on top. But hey, as you're going to keep going, you're going to guard dragon combo like that. Then you're going to normal summon, because you didn't normal summon at all in this combo. Rescue hamster is amazing. Electrum is going to add it back again. Add back two. You play one hamster in this build because it's absolutely amazing. Helps you get lots of plays out. Then you're going to fusion to get the Alkahest. And then you didn't even use Sayusha's effect yet. The second Sayusha effect, so you're going to special the Endymion. And hell, even if I forgot if I did or not, you can just put it in the scale, take out 6 counters from your 20 from Jackal, and summon it. And then here you could go Heretic Link. We are going to go through the deck profile as quick as possible. We got 8 Manifolds out here, but really 14 because we got triple summoners or triple painful decision. You want as many ways to search these as possible by spells instead than actual drawing the monster. That way you have more counters for Abductor and Servant. That's the main part of the deck. You're going to draw Servant or Abductor or Spell Power Mastery. So you need all the spells possible to trigger them. And the second you trigger one, you auto win because your combo is resolving. And 90% of the time, either you resolve it or they don't have a hand trap. One or the other. So you don't even need a Jackal, right? So 90% of that, 10% chance of you not doing of your Electrum getting hand trapped. And then if it gets hand trapped, you just play normal pendulums. You don't play this crazy, incredible, amazing this deck. Now, I was thinking about playing more low skills, but you don't need it because you always end up getting the Servant or Abductor. If you don't have that in low skill, you end up getting it by Electrum. So your low skills always covered. You need more high skills, and that's what really those metaphors are for, with Gold Driver and Painful Decision being like a backup option for low skill. Chronograph, you don't need Time Gazer, you play Metal Foes, you pop a card, special 2. No need for Time Gazer, there's no bricks in this deck aside from the Metal Foes cards. Rescue Hamster puts in absolute work, your second Electrum gets it, because you go double Electrum, right, like the old days. So your second Electrum gets the Hamster, and really searches whatever the hell you want. Sork, Yuga Golem, Coin Dragon, holy shit, this combo's amazing, props to me for doing it. The Doc better be happy and better train me well, so whoop Nerd Trip's ass. One Jackal, one Endymion. All you need. You don't need more. Don't play Cerberus. It hurts too much if it gets Ash. Don't need it. And it conflicts with Servants a little too much. You don't need one Jackal. You only need one Endymion. That's it. No reason for Desires. Too many one-ups. One Destrudo for Guard Dragon combo. Amazing. Doesn't break. It's amazing first or second. Triple Curtain Razor. Triple Unexpected Die. All right. D6 in this deck is way better than Dark Worm and Foolish. Because you don't have Pen Call to discard the Dark Worm. Drawing the Dark Worm sucks. Drawing Dark Worm is a brick. Drawing Dark Worm to me is the same as drawing a Gate Zero. Because you don't want to ever normal summon the Dark Worm. The normal summon is always reserved for the search to rescue Hamster. To continue going off on your plays eventually in the combo. Or if you actually need to for an Electrum, which you don't. Because you got Infinity 1-card Electrums. Now, that means you're playing double Dark Worm, Gate Zero. Which is 3 Garnets and 3 Brilliant Fusion in Foolish and Shrine, right? So why would we want to play 3 Brilliant Fusion, 3 Foolish or Shrine, which are Brilliant Fusions, and 3 Garnets? Why would you do that when instead you could just play 6 Brilliant Fusions with no Garnets, right? So Curtain Razor and Unexpected Die do the job of Foolish or Shrine without playing the bricks. Plus, there are no random monsters like Dark Worm to conflict with the Servants because there are too many monsters with Metal Foes already. You just want infinite spells. Those brick, these don't. Itali, special and spell. Amazing. Painful Summoners are, like I said, you just want infinity spells. You got 20 of them. Curtain Razor counts as a spell because it leaves the scale, and then you need two of the 20 spells and you win. Triple Summoners are triple mastery obvious. One upstart triple into the void. Don't question me on triple painful decision. It's a must with servants and abductors. If you don't play those, even one or two is enough, but you need to see it. Into the void, mandatory for any demon on deck. One fusion, one combination, all you need. Three spirit, two lava golem, all you need. Destroy good decks. Triple ascender, triple MST, so good combination. And destroy Mystic Mind, which is what they're there for. I'm a double tool twister. Mystic Mind's still a threat, but triple MST, triple eccentric, way better than Twister in Metalfoe. Double reboot, a bunch of back row decks I hate for this, and you got eight ways to get rid of Morphid Goliath and all that garbage that you're going to face. All right, next. Electrum, LP, Agar Paint, triple pressure again. Some crazy plays with the second Electrum. Utilizing, if you use your draws are very awkward. The triple pressure dragon lets you make the guard dragon play extremely easily. Heretic Link with no Aether because you're too good for them. You're going to outthink them like crazy. You're going to do unbelievable psychology here. They are going to you're going to think that they're assuming that a Sloth's coming out or an Aether. So you're going to assume that they assume that you're assuming that they assume that you're bringing out another monster with Heretic Seal. So they play around that monster coming out. Joke's on them, no monster's coming out. So you play with them. Two doubles, so use your Boral Sword to OTK their ass. Dragster, Archfiend Abyss, Absolute Vortex. Alka has double Mithrilium. Amazing, I wouldn't change a thing. Deck's absolutely remarkable, all right? Don't go test this list for yourself. It is absolutely broken. Don't even change one card. Test as it is. That's a combo. The potential is endless and limitless, okay? Hope you guys like the video. I hope the Dr. Trip likes this video so you can train me so you can whoop Nerd Trip's ass, okay? Don't forget to subscribe. See you guys in tomorrow's video. Peace. Next time on Trip Gaming.
I want to kill Nerd Trip.
Dr. Trip gives me advice to train so I can destroy Nerd Trip. Is my training enough? Find out next episode of Trip Gaming.